Oh, hi. Hey, I was just tying my shoe because I was trying to get it all ready, and shoes are pretty amazing. And that's the actual project we're gonna do. Today is called From the Sole Up. And this project is really just all about redesigning the shoe from the ground up or from the sole up. Now, we wanna put a little twist on it here and really design it for a specific user because design thinking says that we need to start with a user in mind, and this user is going to be an athlete. So think about what type of athlete you would want to build a shoe for. Maybe what are your hobbies in sports? And then redesign the shoe from the sole up that really gets to the essence, to the soul, if you may, of why they need their shoe. Maybe it's a gymnast, maybe it's a cyclist or a runner, a long distance runner, a sprinter or skier for winter sports, right? But what do they need in their shoe? You're going to walk through the same project steps as normal. Dream it, draw it, and stop on draw it because draw it is very important. I mean, you really need to think about form, function, what are the features. Look at the Inspire 2 video. It's going to give you some great ideas. And then continue on through to the build it. I mean, obviously, the build it is fun, but you've got to stop and really understand who your user is before you build something. Otherwise, you're just building something to build it. So, think about what the needs are. Look on the back here. There's a great think about section. Think about what the shoe is going to be for. Is it what gender is it? What athlete is it? What's their needs? What's their pain points? I mean, shoes are great. I mean, you can be athletic shoes, but rafting shoes are way different. They need to stay on while you're in the raft. Flip-flops are just for just getting around. There's so many different types of shoes, just kind of kicking around, or even dress shoes. Oh, but remember, you've got to work through these steps. Dream it, draw it, build it, share it. And we're gonna make a paper shoe. So let's get cutting. Okay, we're gonna cut out the bottom. You can trace around your actual foot if you want to, so that it kind of fits you and you can make this a smaller or a bigger shoe. It doesn't have to be blue. We just made it nice and blue. Maybe yours come printed out on thin paper. If they do, you can also just cut this out and use it as a template to trace on some scrap cardboard that you might have or cardstock. Cardstock's great because it's nice and flexible, but not too flexible. So, think form function. I'm gonna keep cutting here and we'll get back to it in just a minute. Now I like to get my pieces cut out just a little bit early. So, and then I like to draw on them just to kind of save a little time. But remember, don't cut the blue part or the light shaded part, just along the dark lines. Now, because you'll see that these two are tabs that are gonna glue together on the back. So that's what you're gonna wanna do. Anyway, once you have all the pieces cut out, you've got to make some design decisions. Now, what I like is maybe I want some kind of low tops or something. So I'm just gonna draw here in blue. I kind of want mine to go down more like cons, kind of like that. I want them kind of lower like this. So I'm gonna cut there. Now, yours may be different. You may want to cut something different on yours, but these are what mine are going to do. Now, these two pieces right here, they're going to basically go together, right, like this. So if you're doing that, you want to basically be able to put these two pieces together, and then they're going to wrap around the base of your shoe. Okay? Now, I didn't cut out all these little pieces, so let's do that. Now, these are all going to basically fold down. So what I like to do is take a little ruler here and kind of just bend them all up or down, just so that they're all kind of flat. All right, so remember, bigger tabs are going to be better because you're then going to be able to kind of bend them over like this.
these parking lot next to the meetings. Start to bend them over. You could probably do it
on the side of a desk if you wanted to. That might be nice too.
Right. Now, these are all going to go. I'm going to put the dark side down on my shoe, and then these would just glue together here with the tabs all facing the correct side.
Okay,
right there. I'm going to use my quick grip glue just because I can, but your stick glue works just as good. Put this on here. Okay.
So now you're done with your shoe. You basically, you've got all your parts done, and what you're gonna do is you're going to just attach them all. Just put them all together. Get these pieces here. I'm gonna cut mine smaller, and you glue them in the back, wrap it around. You're gonna get the tongue here. The tongue, you know, make sure it cuts out all the different pieces here. Kind of bend it up like this. Put that's the front of it. Then put the tongue in, glue it down here. If you have some shoelaces or you wanna use our fake ones, that's fine too. But the whole point of this is to be building a shoe for an athlete of your choice. So mine's gonna look different than yours, and that's the beauty of this project is we're walking through steps. Dream it, draw it, build it, share it. And at the end of the day, we do want you to share it. We want to share it with us. So hey, if you find something cool, send us a picture. IntelFutureSkills@intel.com. Until next time, keep making. Mark out. Bye-bye.